Here I'm back again. This is Friday afternoon, and today I'm going to be, or right now I'm going to be kind of drawing, I guess, random stuff. I got to save this file. I got it set up. I forgot to get that set up. So just give me a second here. So I'll be starting on layer one, and I'm just gonna sit here and draw. I don't have any particular ideas or anything, but kind of keep it a little bit relaxed. I'm not gonna get too crazy with anything. Just more practice than anything. And see if I can get any ideas for your future drawings and paintings, digital, whatever. More or less just kind of having fun. So before I started streaming, there was a massive amount of rain down where I live, over here in the Orlando area, Florida. Well, outside of Orlando, but hoping it wouldn't knock my internet out. So typically with eyes here, you don't go like this and put white, complete white. It just doesn't, it's not realistic. And I'm not, you know, doing anything particular. I'm just kind of keeping it simplistic right now. This could be an absolute fail if I'm, you know, being honest. But it's always good to show even the failures. It's always interesting when you capture some of the actual skin color. It can come out a lot different than what you think it is. Edit to this. Just kind of keep going, kind of working through it. Doesn't look great right now, but hopefully I can change that. So one thing I noticed, nose is definitely not that low. So that will kind of raise everything else. It's just kind of noticing these adjustments as you go. Just trying to fix everything. Definitely a lot to be fixed here. It's all about just kind of finding the planes of the head. That's key. And the overall shape, trying to get an accurate depiction here as possible. I'm just kind of keeping this simple. I like simple in the beginning stages. Let's kind of play around with. Still just kind of keep trying to keep it simple. Trying to get these planes correct. Also the color distribution. So I think I'm gonna need to add a little bit more red. It's a little bit too much brown for me as far as comparing it to the reference. Right now, I like to keep the brush fairly large. I don't want to get too bogged down by details. And that's got me in trouble before. Kind of keeping this thing. Eventually, I'm gonna have to go in here and add some details to the eyes. Maybe kind of. Exaggerate a little bit. get some creative stuff going on in here. I'm just kind of winging this. It's not nothing in particular. I'm sticking with, right now, I'm using the thick oil paint brush. I need to just think about blending some of this. Sorry about that. That was a phone call. I gotta put my phone on do not disturb. Just kind of working this. Hope this is showing up decently enough on the stream. Let's kind of give this a curvature. Just kind of randomly doing this. Just kind of working out. Not perfect, but a few things I need to fix here. So definitely the bottom part of the eye either needs to come up. Just kind of keep going. like to keep that warm color. And the cheek area. Add a little bit more red. It's all just kind of exaggerating. And that's something I kind of need to practice a little bit more. I need to make things, like, instead of carbon copies of things, I'd like to make it more artistic. Kind of losing the edges on there. I think it's sort of the purpose. Just kind of I'm not liking the edge of edge work over here too much. It's a little bit too crisp, I think. Go with regular oil paint. See what color's actually in there. So this has got like kind of a reddish. Just keep on refining some of this. So this is where the hair will be illuminated. Just a little bit on the side here. A little bit of red in the nose area, just a little bit, not too strong. So this is going to be a challenge, the hair. I've never been great at it, so it's... Still feeling, I think I need to do some editing. Just kind of playing around with the controls. It's definitely not what I want to do. I don't know if I like that. I mean, it's more... All right, just sort of adjusting here. So I want to kind of add, let's get rid of this, some kind of design that I can Of course, none of this is final. This is just kind of me playing around and trying to figure something out with the, at least in regards to the design. Arm goes like that. So I may change a few things in here. Just kind of playing around. See, this is kind of taking me. Keep this kind of dark back here. It has some light hitting there. Here. I don't know if I'm feeling this. It's kind of no plan, kind of backfiring on me a little bit. I don't know if I want to continue this or stop it right now. That's kind of interesting. So these kind of look like horns from the Cape Buffalo. That's not some, a little bit of purple in there. Kind of like that, using that shade. Let's go with this blue. Hair, man, it really needs a lot of work, and I can see it. Let's kind of give it a gradient here. Let's change this to like another horn. All right, that's interesting. So this is like an armor piece. And I'm liking this blue. As some of the shading elements. Darkness in there. Yeah. So, all right, it's not bad. Now I gotta fix this kind of helmet design. And this purple going to look. Time to tackle this hair. It's difficult to get that, you know, the thickness. Let's smooth some of this out. So this has got to look like it's actually setting on her head rather than like an add-on. So one way you can do that is, you know, the shadow is kind of reflecting or covering kind of down to. It looks like it's setting on her head. So. Something kind of interesting. Should be darker this in this direction. Should be pretty dark over here. and this entire like horn. Let's make it pretty dark because it's in shadow. And then at the tip, maybe we can add some lighter, a lighter section like that. So that'll show kind of where the light is kind of hitting. Let's keep this pretty dark in here. So I pretty much created this character from scratch. Get some of that purple in there. That's kind of a nice, cool color to put in with the blue. I'm just gonna have to work with this hair here. That's all I'm able to get it. Just get it to my liking. Bad so far. So this area I'm gonna have to start smoothing a little bit of blue in there. Just to make it interesting. So as you can see to the left, there's the entrance, the reference, sorry about that. So if you want kind of a smoother brush, the round mixing brush right here will help. keep the shape interesting here. Add some So let's kind of play with the shadows here. So the horn needs to project a shadow. So that should kind of go like this. And then likewise over here. Have some individual like pieces of hair kind of overlapping in there. Kind of make this interesting shape right here. I like this kind of ornamental design. Keep this dark. Not too much detail in there. Pull this here. Everything interesting. Now, don't shy away from certain colors. cleaning these areas up. Some lighter color in there. Let's kind of play around with them. So once again, this is facing the light, and as it kind of curves around here, it'll lose some of that. Then as it goes in here, less light hits. I want to add a little bit of her skin in there. Kind of want to keep this ornamental design going. This armor, interesting. let's go up and refine a little bit more here. I don't know how far down I want to take this. If I want to make it a whole piece or more robust. Really work on that, on the hair. It's kind of a big deal. Kind of treating it like big chunks, big pieces here, rather than like individual little strands, like 3D pieces. Big chunk here. Lock it out. So this is a reflective material. I'm gonna add some of the skin color into that. Maybe some of the hair. And likewise over here. And then this one here, some of the this color here. These are just three-dimensional. So I'm gonna work with this color, and it's gonna be, it's kind of, I like this armor design. Pretty cool. And I literally just made this up as I went. There was no, not a whole lot of planning for this, but it seemed like it, I was not doing a very good job in the beginning, but I kind of pushed through. As you go further, I want to kind of lessen the impact of the So at this point, I'm just kind of doing things from my imagination. Oh, this is like random. let's kind of fix this up, make it look really crisp as I can get it. Because it's a kind of jaggy right now. Jagged, jaggy, whatever. Wonder, making a slight adjustment here. The sun just a little bit. A little bit better. I think the head was kind of bothering me. Interesting shapes in here. There's definitely some cool shapes in here. I'm actually liking the armor design. It's a little weird, but that's okay. by something like this. Keep it kind of loose down here. To keep it darker. Kind of interesting. And I could use this as a character if I wanted to. Some of that blue. So I gotta be able to get some of this armor design into the legs. I want to go too All Let's keep on going. This little detail. Just, I gotta make the top, the bottom part is interesting as the top here. So I can't just neglect the leg area. A little bit of highlight there. Nope, that's not what I wanted. To pull out on my next session with this. I'm gonna have to get kind of some anatomy. Let's go up here. Just trying to think if it's accurate. So let's see here. Let me get some reference here. Sorry, I'm pulling up some reference. Okay, here we go. So I'm gonna go with this color here. Kind of use the colors that are Let's sneak some of that pink color in there. So this might add like a secondary lighting. It's kind of interesting. All right. So the hands are going to be important because that always determines usually if you're good or not. I want to have some of this stuff up here. I think this will benefit from some of the red skin tone. It's kind of giving it this surreal kind of look to it. So let's kind of play with thank you. So far, I'm only on one layer, so. So just keep on going, keep on. You can see I have the reference on left hand side. I use that to create this, and it just kind of shows you how I use reference. I loosely use it in the beginning, or I use it in the beginning, and then I just kind of work off of that and kind of design my own thing afterwards. Looking something sharp, like some interesting. Something like this. Just trying to keep the silhouette. Has to be interesting from top to bottom. I'm gonna have to work a little bit on this bottom area a little bit later, but kind of get some of the darks in here. All right, so I don't like how this is even. See this? That's not good. So I am, this left leg is bothering me. So I'm gonna have to play around with this. Because it's not good when it's like an even level, that's very boring. Like it's gotta be that looks broken. You know, back here or something. On a different, completely different level, but right now, you know, the legs are kind of honestly a little bit stiff. I can approach this differently. So let me go back with the thick oil paint. I've been kind of on that other one for a while. Kind of go like that. But based on the size, the legs are too short. So an adjustment is needed. I'm thinking let's go like this. It's more like that. I think that works. And let's move the entire portrait or drawing. This is kind of giving me some all right, this is gonna have to be something that I'm gonna have to come back with like fresh eyes. Because right now it's not working. Something like that. I don't like that. It's just stiff. Maybe I just kind of worked my way into a roadblock here. I like everything from here up. This leg, I'm just not liking it. I don't know if I should go. Try to do something. I mean, honestly, this leg isn't even that good either. It looks, it's not even like, it's kind of like problem solving on the go here. Change the brushes, that's kind of slowing the software down a little bit. Try it. Maybe let's use this one. I can maybe deal with this. Workable here. Yeah, a lot of adjustments needed for the next round here. So I gotta have purpose for this pose. It can't just be. Random. So the interesting thing is the top. I'm gonna have to really work next on the bottom part here. And the legs don't look good right now, but that's what I have. So I'm going to end the stream right now. I'm thinking, something. Lines like that. Not too light, but something like this. I want to quit. Some of this is same kind of design on this side. I don't know if I want to do any asymmetric. Oops, wrong. Actually, that's could work. This is kind of gotta go. It's kind of goes into there. It's turning out pretty good. As I kind of said, I was going to end the stream. I'm wondering. Way too big. Way too big. Make sure you know the proportions are as correct as I can get it. Fix some of these proportions here. This is the convenience of having digital. Still think it's a little bit too, the head is a little bit too large for my okay, that's a little bit more. Proportional. Hate that problem. It's kind of adjusting here. It's a little bit better. It's really just kind of recognizing these mistakes, because leg. Let's see. Kind of like that. And then it's a trick to this. We draw a circle. You don't want the limbs to look broken. All right, I am going to stop the stream for now. Thank you for any who have tuned in. And just check out my YouTube channel, or, you know, kind of stay tuned on here on Twitch. Thank you for tuning in, and hope to see you a little bit later.